I am Dr. Heather Moore, owner of Total Performance Physical Therapy. Tonight we are going to talk about how the cold weather affects neck and shoulder pain. And of course this came up today, which is why we are discussing it, and a lot of people don't realize how much the cold weather affects your body, affects your muscles, not just your joints. And of course everyone's thinking, well, I need to go to Florida, I need to retire to Florida. You know, I'm not an arthritic person like my grandparents, so I don't have to worry about that. But for some reason, I get increased headaches, my shoulders start to hurt, my lower back starts to hurt. Things really have, you know, turned the corner in the last week or two as the temperatures where we are have dropped significantly. So we need to kind of go over a little bit of why that happens. And the biggest reason is because of guarding. And when you get cold, your body has a reaction that causes it to shiver, shrug. It causes it to try and generate some heat, and it causes it to move in patterns that it shouldn't be moving. So if you're sitting there and you're shivering, or you're sick and you're shivering, and a lot of times that's why when you have a cold and you've been blowing your nose and you're shivering and you get done shivering and you're like, oh my gosh, I feel like I've worked out. I feel like I've done, you know, a difficult workout. It's because you sat here shivering. A lot of people will walk out into the cold and not even know it and just be like this with their shoulders elevated. So it's really important, if you suffer from any sort of neck or shoulder pain, that you recognize that if you're shivering or if you're cold, even though you may not realize it, you're actually doing some techniques that will guard against that, will allow your body to generate some heat. But by generating that heat, what you're going to do is you're going to cause yourself to have headaches. You're going to cause yourself neck and shoulder pain. It's like when you go to the gym, if you take your top off too early, you're going to wind up exercising and being a little cold. Well, you're going to try and generate that warmth from, you're going to try and generate that warmth from activating some of the muscles in your body. So you could wind up doing a lot of exercising with improper form, especially if you get to the studio or the gym or wherever you're working out and it's cold. So you want to really take note of that, and you want to make sure that if you do suffer from neck pain, back pain, or maybe you just started, you want to see how you are reacting to the cold weather. Are you sleeping at night? Are you, you know, having to curl up in a little ball to get warm? Those types of constant contraction of your muscles really makes it painful and really can cause a lot of issues and a lot of damage. And people don't always relate it, because whatever, your body's just shivering like it, and it's going to shiver all over sometimes. But most of the time when you're shivering, it's up here in your shoulders and in your neck, and that's going to cause those muscles to fire and cause you either numbness and tingling down your arm, headaches up into your head, shoulder pain, neck pain, all the above. So what are you going to do about it? Well, obviously the first answer is you're going to get a jacket. You're going to warm up. And I know that sounds strange, but unfortunately that's the only way you're going to help your body garner that heat that it needs. It needs to warm up. So if you provide that warmth through a jacket, a coat, a warm shower, whatever it may be, it's going to allow your body the ability to relax a little bit. The other thing you can do is when you're shivering, you basically need to tell yourself to stop, all right? So whatever that is, whether you, if you don't have access to a coat, taking deep breaths, roll your shoulders up, back, and drop them down. Really relaxing your shoulders, trying to get that good posture. If you're winding up with that pain in your back, same thing with your back. Just trying to do nice, gentle shoulder rolls, nice, gentle posture to allow yourself to stop this and to stop that constant contraction. I mean, just from demonstrating to you right now during this short little video, I actually feel sore in my shoulders because I've just been doing this, and it's not something you're used to doing. So it's that constant spasm. So you want to roll your shoulders up, back, drop them down, take a deep breath. You want to make sure that if you are someone that you know is prone to chills and prone to being cold, and you also suffer from headaches or neck pain or shoulder pain, that you have an extra layer on you, so you are not going to wind up shivering or shaking or trying to get warm, that you have that ability to do that without using the extra muscles in order to do so. At night, you want to make sure that you have extra covers. There's nothing really you can do, but one of the worst things you can do is scrunch up into a little ball and try and stay there for the night. Your body will let you, but in that respect, you're going to have 8 hours or 5 hours or however long you sleep of you being like this, and all that is activating these muscles. So you're going to wind up with that numbness and tingling, possibly herniating a disc, neck pain, shoulder pain. So all these things you need to think about with the cold weather, going out and warming up your car so you're not sitting there trying to drive and have your shoulders up near your ears, making sure that you're doing everything you can to allow your shoulders and your arms and your neck to have a rest.